Alright, YouTube fam, what's going on, y'all? So, we finally made it inside. It's after 10 o'clock. We're here looking at the bike and stuff. I'm over here at the BMW section, and this is what I'm going to be riding today, fam. I am getting on the 2017 BMW S1000 Double R, bitch. What? Is you serious, son? Yes, he is. Oh, I'm sorry. This is a 2016 model. My fault. It's right here on the key tab. Let's take a quick look at everything. This is the one I'm going to get in. 2016 BMW S1000 RR color, white and blue, series, demo, VIN Z3546 4D or 40, something like that. All right, let's go ahead and sit on it real quick. I can flat foot it. Yep, I am flat footing the BMW S1 RR both sides. Yeah, see what it feel like. Oh yeah, this feels nice compared to the Gixxers and stuff, I must say. But my complaint would be that rear brake pedal is a little low compared to what I'm used to. Man, it'd be really nice, son. Yeah. Gear indicator in neutral, sport mode. Got all this stuff that I don't need. All these ABS. Well, ABS is the only thing I need on the motorcycle. Ooh, listen to that. I thought it was sensitive. Not as loud as I was expecting it to be. But then again, this is a stock exhaust and stuff on it, so of course it's not going to be as loud as you expect. That'd be nice though. I can definitely see me owning this. Yeah, it's nice. Got all these modes and stuff right here. Let's see what they are. Sport, race, rain. Keep that being sport, son. I don't know what that is. Traction control or something, I don't know. ABS, what's all this? Now off on, set, reset. You gotta have my ABS. Oh, it got a quick shifter. Oh, that's nice. It's quick. It's headlight or a quick shifter, I can't tell.
Pass
light, okay.
You're on the track, you click that.
Oh, the passing light, okay. There we go. Got somebody from a track here who know what they talking about. I also don't know shit.
Right,
oh snap. I'm over here doing all this stuff about this one, like, yeah, this one I'm finna ride.
I'm like, I only see one in the motorsport color.
Damn. I mean, they both the same bike, they both nice.
Yeah.
But hey, let me tell you, see what this one feel like. Black. I like that blue though. Yeah, this. Yeah. I mean, it don't matter at this point, I just wanna ride the bike.
Right? It's not even
BMW S1. Let me turn it on one more time. Slick. See, look at this. All these damn control stuff. All right, got it. Left turn, left blinker, right blinker, off. Has a light. Bam. ABS. Nothing's changing. So I don't know. Got trip. Last. Okay, here we go. 1420. 135. It says the limit. Race info. Ain't got no race info. Setup menu. I got a bunch of stuff on here. Jesus Christ, these settings and configurations. I don't need none of that. If I get the bike, I will learn all that stuff. But for the most part, I don't need that shit, you know? Alright, YouTube fam. So, ooh, wee. It's hot. But I don't give a damn. It's finally time, baby. We loading up. Once again, your boy Psychotic Heart is here on the 2016 BMW S1000RR.
I'll help you through those gears if you decide not to use your clutch on that clutch shift.
Yep. All right. This bike is equipped with a clutchless shift assist. I have cruise control, ABS, traction control, rain mode, heated grips, and a bunch of other doohickeys that I'm not gonna use whatsoever. Looks like we're gonna be the first ones out. Yep. Woohoo! So far the seating position is very aggressive. And I like it. I like it a lot. Woo! Smooth. Now, the one of the BMW people were talking about how you're going to get a bit of heat coming off the engine on here, on the double R, because of the way the fairings are positioned on here. Well, that's fine for me. No, I'm going to get a little. Woo, this bike just, it just turns, baby. It just wants to lean. Oh my God. I feel like chasing two wheels right now giving the review, bitch. I'm still in first, by the way, so. Yep, there is that clutchless shift. Just put your foot down there on the knob and you're good to go. Whoo, damn. Damn, barely touching the brake. Got it. I got a nice little gear indicator here too. Woo. That's back brake. That front brake though, look at that. Look at this. Barely touching it and it's kind of launching me forward a little bit. It's awesome. This is Davy Jones, our leader here. Yes, everybody, his name is Davy Jones. What? Oh my God, I'm loving it. What? That power? And when we came around that curve, this bike, it just wants to go over. So light. Oh man, this is magnificent. Now, I truly understand why so many people love the BMW S1000. Oh, found neutral. There we go. Found neutral. Like I said before, I got a gear indicator. Quick shifter down here. I can shift with or without the clutch. Got a cruise control. One of these buttons. I got a hole in my glove right there. Fucking awesome. There's somebody else right there too. So we're going out in three groups, man. I hate that this is the only demo ride I'm going to get to do. And that's because, again, it is after 11. I had to ask my wife to check out the hotel for us. Because I'm here to do the demo ride, man. I said, I gotta get in at least one demo ride, bro. At least one. Had to do it. Woo, look at that. Going 50 in first. Dude, this shit goes up 16,000 RPMs. I'm only in second gear right now, and I'm going 60. This, oh man, this bike. This bike is mad comfortable. Mad fucking comfy. You gotta turn signal. Ah, come on, man. You're being a noob. Hit your signal. Hit your blinker. Woo. Yes, love. I mean, it sucks I can't open the bike up the way I want to. I want to see how fast I can get this bike to 100. With being a BMW S1000RR, oh my God, that lane changing was like butter. So smooth, so crispy, fam. On steer code, yes, Lord, I am coding. Dude, this is a super sport. I can see me taking on a long trip because it is incredibly comfy right now. And the mirrors are actually good. I can actually see the other bikes behind me. Give a little bit of gas to catch up. It's had no wheelies. It's a good thing I'm not a stunner anyway, so wheelies is not something that I'm going to be doing. But oh my God, this is beautiful. This is beautiful. We're making a right turn. Turning right, everybody. Take it down. Second kind of quick shift without. Yep, quick shift going down. Oh, it's gonna hit this turn. Woo, that power coming out of that turn, boy. What you mean, son? Woo! Yeah! Oh, I fucking love this bike. I want it.
The MSRP on this one here, the double R is what they had back there, the loading area and everything, or whatever you want, whatever the hell you want to call the area we were waiting in before we got on the bikes to go riding and stuff. The MSRP was 18,000 something. So you can say that whatever the MSRP is, you may as well add like between four and six grand to that. So it's at 18,000 something. I'm just gonna go off rip and say this bike's about $22,000-$23,000 out the door at a dealership. Maybe if you go to a BMW dealership, maybe it'll be a little cheaper, maybe it won't be. But man, this bike, one of the things I would change on this bike is the exhaust, because I'm pretty sure you guys can hear me crystal clear, minus whatever little bit of wind noise you guys may or may not hear. So other than that, I'll change the exhaust. Woo! See what the engine braking like. Down a second. All right, engine braking pretty strong. Down the first. Yeah, that engine braking. Oh yeah, you definitely feel that engine braking, son. But yo, I'm using the back brake mostly because, like I said, it's front brakes. We got these ABS Brembos on the front here, son. These shits are mad fucking sensitive as hell, bro. You don't understand. Now let me angle the camera down a little bit, so this way you guys probably have a better view of my console and everything. But I'm still in first. But you know what I like about this too? Is with the quick shift assistant that they have on it, you don't have to feather the throttle in order to shift either. You can just stay on the throttle. See, watch my right hand here. I'm finished. Shift up third. I'm standing up. Not gonna move at all. And now I'm in third. Just like that. It's just that fucking simple, son. It's amazing. How's it going over there, buddy? Yo, it rested one hand off. Fuck that. I'm two hands on, son. I want the full experience. Let me tuck it down. That tuck feels nice. Got my knees on. I mean, my elbows on my knees right now. That tuck is nice. Y'all need to catch up back there, fam. But they said they don't want nobody riding above their comfort zone. I always do a little hand signal to let everybody know we're gonna turn. Woo! Woo! Boy, that, oh my God. Dude, this, if you get a BMW S1000 RR 2016 or newer, you have to. Okay, do you hear me? You have to. You cannot buy this bike and never take it to the track for as long as you have it. At some point, you gotta go to the fucking track, son. Woo! It is nice! Damn, but we're leaving the back of the group. Oh, not even now. We're going. Just us, we got riding in a staggered formation. I want to just break off from the group, man, and just take off. I want to, like, turn somewhere, but we got a second person following the group and stuff. So if I just happen to randomly disappear, they can be like, what the fuck? I mean, they know how many S1000 RRs we got out here right now. So I unfortunately can't just do that. But yeah, today is Sunday, October 16th. The day after Sub D was in town, from what I understood when I met up with Sub D yesterday, they were supposed to be on the plane first thing this morning on their way back to Cali. So Sub D, if you're watching this video, man, I want to thank you guys for coming out. Had a great time, even though I only got to see you for a little bit. I wanted to make it out there to the bar with you guys last night, but I was out so late yesterday at the expo and then out riding with my friends that my wife was mad at me. So I told her I'd make it up to her by taking her out to dinner. We went wherever she wanted. We went to this place called Ponderosa. It was really fucking good. So, well, next time y'all in town, I'll be able to kick it with y'all a lot more, man. So, once again, great big shout out to Sub D, Shade Tree Surgeon, Z, RPS TV, Dank Willie, Mr. Moto Pete, and all the other guys I met out here at the AIM Expo meetup, man. It's nice meeting you guys. Hopefully, we'll all get to ride together again sometime in the near future. But now, back to this fucking bike, son. This shit, son. Oh my God, it's beautiful. Pardon me once, yes. Got a little red bomb. Oh, we turn it right. Hold up, wait a minute. Come on, car, get out of our way. Thank you. Between engine braking and barely touching this front brake, shit, I ain't gotta worry about crashing into no damn body.
Yo, that front brake is so sensitive.
Got a nice little windy road they done found here, son. No, I had a dream last night that I was riding a fucking super sport bike, and I was not wearing a I was not wearing a track suit, so I actually had so much lean on there without realizing I drug my knee on the damn road and shit. And dude, in my dream, when I stopped and got off the bike, man, oh my god, when I tell you my knee was fucked up, like, dude, you put it this way, in my dream, I could see the damn bone of my fucking knee, son. That's just how aggressive I was. It was only for a split second too, so it's like I was wearing shorts. So I was probably on a damn Gixxer. I was probably being a Gixxer bro. Oh my god, Shingle Creek. What? Yeah, okay, I see what she was talking about now. I can actually feel the heat from the engine coming off and onto my left leg here. I can feel the heat. My right leg is staying perfectly cool, but my left leg, I can feel the heat coming off the engine. So, I mean, as long as you're moving like I am right now, it's really not that big of a problem. Not that bad. So, it's manageable while I'm riding, but I can imagine if you're sitting at a red light or if you're stuck in traffic because lane filtering is not legal where you live, and like myself, you don't actually go ahead and filter. I do filter. I live in the state of Florida. Lane filtering is not legal here, but I lane filter. I don't give a damn. My motto is traffic is for cars, so fuck that, son. You are not going to tell me that I'm on a motorcycle and I have to be stuck in traffic because of all these cars that people got on the road with all these damn rubbernecks and stuff. Fuck that. I filter. I filter hard, son. Ah! Y'all got that ass, bitch! We got split off a little bit. Ooh, my god. Hitting that motherfucking, that gas, boy. So, we not gonna wait for them to catch up? Alright, cool, fuck them. We got split. We got split off. Oh, look like they're coming now. Yeah. Stop time. It look like they're catching up now.
So we're gonna stop and wait for the group now. Oh, there they go. Ready to go whenever you are, Davy Jones.
Holy shit, I can't believe his name is. That's actually his name.
Yo, yo.
Dude, clutchless shifting is badass as fuck. I can really get damn used to this, son. Like, I am so serious. Alright, they said we only got two left turns on our route, and this is... okay, I thought this was one of them. Get a little tuck action. Yeah! I mean, they told us they don't want us doing what I did right there. Letting off a clutch a little bit and then throttle a little bit and then slamming it to catch up. I mean, I'm doing it, but I'm not necessarily doing it on purpose. That's the funny thing. Look at these guys. How y'all doing? Gixxer?
Yeah.
I love it just to get over there beside them and just like, you want to go, bro? You want to go, bro? Yeah, we on Beamers, bro. Yeah. BMW Mercy. Yo, chick, she's so thirsty. I'm on that BMW, so now you want to jerk me. My remix. Yeah, I'm starting to feel some heat on my shoes. Like, my damn shoe itself is heating up now. But yeah, my exhaust is definitely, the heat off the engine is definitely pretty intense down on your ankle. Like, from my ankle, from the top of my ankle down to the bottom of my heel, that's where I can feel that my foot is starting to heat up. So, I mean, it depends on how you want to view it. Yeah, we back already? Damn, that was fast. But then again, I was jamming that hoe. Yeah, but see, the thing is, even though it has a quick shifter, when it comes to you stopping and going and stuff, of course you have to. You still gotta pull in the clutch. But other than that, no.
I want to go again. Yeah, I want to just break off and just go. Oh man, this bike is awesome. The only thing I don't like is the heat coming off on my foot.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the only downside. Other than that, this bike is beautiful. The next group. We got Booster Bro. Come on, Booster Bro, speed up. Here's the rest. Got a bunch of guys on the dual sports. I saw Suzuki right there, just pulled that. But yo, son, this fucking BMW. My overall rating for 2016 BMW. Hey, damn. That's what I was saying. My overall rating for the 2016 BMW S1000 RR. This is a great, magnificent bike to have, especially if you want to take it to the track. This would be a perfect track bike. And even though I am someone who's never been to a track, I can still say that this will be a perfect bike for you to take to a track, because like I said, coming from someone who's never been to a track, when this bike is in these twisties, these curves and stuff, and I go to lean into it, it just goes. See, look at this shit, son. It just goes. It just flows like nothing. I mean, I have mad confidence that I can take this fucking bike to Blood Mountain and be an intermediate level rider instantly. That's just how comfortable and how much praise I'm putting into this bike. My first time riding a BMW motorcycle, BMW S1000 RR 2016 model, and I have my own, like I said, my only head up, there's cops. My only complaint about this bike is with the heat coming off the engine onto your left foot. That's the only complaint I have. Other than that, this bike is fucking perfect, magnificent, wonderful. It's fast, it's light, the gearing and everything is crisp. Shit. Alright, man, I'm doing the best I can to give you guys a good fucking review. So I don't know all the terminology and everything. I'm not that good of a review person. I'm no Chase on Two Wheels. If you guys want to see somebody do an awesome review on this motorcycle, look into Chase on Two Wheels if you don't know who he is or if you're not already subscribed to him. Check him out. Check out his channel. He constantly does reviews, and he's one of those people. He gets excellent angles. Oh, shit, he's kicking up rocks and stuff. He gets all the angles. He has a setup where he can get put a microphone next to the bike and you can properly hear every damn thing about it. You can get a clear picture of what the bike truly sounds like when you're out riding it and stuff like that. So yeah, if you want someone to do a better review, hit up Chase on Two Wheels. Get in touch with his page, drop him an email or something, ask him if he can do a first ride for the BMW S1000 RR. And he will tell you, just like I'm telling you, this is a fucking amazing bike, man. Thank you.
address. I want to see where this
is. Oh, it's going to be on YouTube.
Yeah. What I look for. You got to give me that.
My channel name is A Psychotic Heart.